Hi, welcome to PiSignage. My name is Rajat and I look at all things design and product here at PiSignage. Today's video is an overview of the platform and a quick demo of what's possible with PiSignage. It's not going to exhaustively cover all of the features we have, and there will be future videos where we expand on each specific feature, but today's video is just a quick demo to showcase the platform and help you decide if PiSignage is the right fit for you. To begin with, let me explain what PiSignage is a little bit. It's a digital signage software to centrally manage all of the screens you have across locations from a single place. You could upload your assets, videos, PDFs, PowerPoints, web links, whatever it is, and display them on multiple screens with a single click of a button. And you could schedule them, you could time them, and you could do many other things, all using PiSignage. We have restaurants that showcase the same menu across multiple locations. We have ad agencies that manage multiple screens and schedule ads between screens across malls, airports, buses, and many other locations. We have churches, schools, government institutions that actually display the information, photos, videos, and even messages and news, all using PiSignage. So for today's setup, we do have a screen playing an asset that we have already deployed. All of this is playing from the Raspberry Pi. The Raspberry Pi was the initial hardware that PiSignage was built on, and it continues to remain our preferred hardware. However, we do have an Android player, we do have a PWA player, and we do have a player that works on any Chrome-based browser. If you want to try a player yourself, you could simply go to PiSignage.com/player2 and register the same. All links I mentioned will be available in the description below. Every account comes with 2 free players and a lifetime subscription for each of the players. So I would highly encourage you to go to PiSignage.com/signup, and you should be able to sign up with just your email address, no credit cards required. Experience the platform with your 2 free players and decide for yourself if the platform is for you. So let's dive into the platform. On signing up, you should see something like this, which is a guide map that allows you to upload your first asset and get started immediately. For this video, I'm just going to go over the 5 main functions that help you manage your players. I'm going to go over each of these in detail, but there is the dashboard, players, groups, assets, and playlists, and this is what helps you manage your players. The dashboard essentially helps you get a good overview of all your players. It helps you identify which players are online right now, which players haven't reported in the past few days, and which assets, playlists, etc. are running and which locations are active. You could even see information like if a player was turned on but the TV was turned off. We next have players. Players is where all of your screens show up. Over here we can see demo TV, which is the TV that we have right here. You can see information like the player ID, the IP address, the version, when was it last reported, etc. You could also see what is the current playlist, the group, and the status, which would indicate whether it's online, whether it's playing a playlist, or whether the TV is off, etc. You also have the terminal and settings icon. The settings icon is straightforward, which helps you rename the player, change the assigned group, etc. You could also click on the terminal icon, and this would help you run shell commands. You could turn on the TV, turn off the TV, and it also gives you a good preview of what is currently playing on that screen. Now, we have customers who have multiple screens across locations, and this is why we have groups. Groups are nothing but a group of players which can all be assigned the same settings, the same playlist, just so that it makes it easier to manage a large group of players all at once. In the beginning, all accounts come with a default group, and this default group runs a specific playlist, which is the playlist that it will default to when nothing else is scheduled. You can have specific deploy options. You could schedule additional playlists, which would simply allow you to place a playlist, select the calendar icon, and tell the player when to schedule this given playlist. For now, I'm just going to delete this. You could set a group ticker. You could view the schedule. You could also go into settings, which allow you to change the resolution, allow for dual screen support, allow for animations, etc. For all the players in this group. For now, I'm simply going to click on blend for our any future assets. So now that we have covered groups, I'm going to move on to assets. Assets form a core of what is deployed and a core of what is shown on all screens. Over here, we currently have video one, which is what is playing over here. All assets have validity, which you could choose not to set, which means that the asset always remains valid. But in case you choose to add a validity, the validity helps you decide how long is the asset valid for, and if the asset should be made invalid, in which case it is removed from all screens and not shown on any screens post the validity period. You could assign it to a playlist, you could delete, download the same. For now, let me upload an asset, and over here you can see by clicking add, I can upload a file, which could be a photo, video, PDF. You could add a link, which would be a web link, a YouTube link, a streaming RSS link, whatever you want. You could add a message or create a notice, or add a local folder file, which would pull a local folder or file that's already within the Raspberry Pi or device that you choose to display from. For now, to keep things simple, I'm just going to click on upload asset, and I'm going to click on video 2, which we are going to now upload. Any asset that is uploaded may also get converted, just to make sure that it's compressed and it is of the right format to show on all screens. You could add categories, which will help you filter and sort all of your assets, and you could add a validity period right here. I'm going to click on continue. It'll warn me about any conversions that have happened. And over here, you can see video2_C has now been uploaded. From here, we're going to move on to playlists. Playlists essentially are a group of assets that may have specific properties and specific layouts in terms of how they're shown, which are then deployed to the groups or players individually. Every account comes with a default playlist or a TV off playlist. The default playlist is a base playlist that is like every other playlist. The TV off playlist is something we call a special playlist. In this case, a TV off playlist turns the TV off whenever it's scheduled. This is great for scenarios where you want to turn off the screen at night or turn off the screen during particular days. You could use the TV off playlist to turn off the TV. Currently, the default playlist is playing, and when you go into a playlist, you can kind of see all of the assets that are included, along with options like setting a ticker, setting a layout, previewing and deploying the same. For now, I'm just going to go back to playlists and create something I'm going to call my first playlist. I click on add. I select the two assets that I want to include in this playlist. I can change their duration, I can mute the audio, or I could include a text message over the same. I could also add a layout which would split the screen, probably have a 3-panel screen or a 4-panel screen to show multiple assets at the same time. This is also particularly useful if you want to show an RSS feed along with these two assets. So now that we have our playlist, I'm going to go back to our group. We said that default group is the group that we were on. You can show the players that currently are part of it. And I'm simply going to go to the default playlist, choose my first playlist, and click on deploy. Now, I could choose to schedule the deploy for later, in which case I could say it's scheduled daily, monthly, or I could just schedule it for a specific time in the future. But for now, I'm just going to click on deploy, which is then going to send the request to all of our players. In this case, it's this player. You can see that the download happened, and now the screen has been updated with all of the assets we put into the playlist. We have our first asset over here, and soon it should change to our second asset. There's that blend animation that we talked about earlier as well. So now that we have covered how to maintain and run your players, I'm just going to quickly cover the other tabs that we have here. You have the subscription and license tab, which allows you to purchase player licenses and 1-year subscriptions. This is mainly to register your players and keep them running on a yearly basis. You could purchase them right from here, and we allow for PayPal, Stripe, and even INR purchases through PaysPay. We then have reports, which will help you understand how long players have been running, how long have TVs been turned on, what assets have been playing, and this should help you generate reports so that you could build clients or even just on your own understand how all of your players have been doing. You have settings which help you manage your entire platform and your entire org, which could be things like custom logos, installation settings, and more. You have a guide map which you can always access, and this is what you would first land on. You have template designer, which is where you could create custom layouts which would then be added to the playlist, like the split screen view, etc. And you have your clients, where certain resellers use to manage their clients and their client IDs. So that brings us to the end of the video. We're hoping that this gave you a good overview of everything that's possible on the platform. Obviously, we've not been able to touch on every single feature. We will be creating a future set of videos that will expand on each feature and even touch upon how to register and set up your first player. With that being said, I would highly urge you to go to pisignage.com/signup, create your first account, and experience the platform yourself with the two free players that come with every account. With that, thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.